Hello everyone, welcome to Sacred Tarot by Nicole. I'm very excited to have you here today for my very first video on YouTube. I've been wanting to do this for a while. I'm very excited to share experiences that I've had in life with metaphysical healing, manifestation, and using my tarot cards as a divination tool. I have been an energy worker for over 20 years. Started out with astrology when I was 12 years old and then moved on to reading tarot cards when I was 15. So I just aged myself there. Now I want to introduce my cards. They're very special to me. They are smaller, but I do like the size. I don't even know if they make them like this anymore. They're very, very sweet. Now I'll show you a couple of the illustrations here. So that's the world. Get a little closer. Right there. So the illustrator here is Mary Hansen Roberts. She does a really good job of expressing herself through her artwork on all the cards, and the energy that comes off of the cards are really, really, really nice and really powerful. It's the Lovers, one of my favorite cards. Now I do use other tarot decks for my readings. I just wanted to introduce that deck specifically because that was a tarot deck that I was gifted when I was 15 years old. It's my very first tarot deck. It's very special to me. There is a lot of information out there about how to do things, what to do, how to do it. And I just wanted to mention about metaphysical healing, manifestation, and tarot card readings that energy workers might have a different technique or developed a different ability or skill. So one energy worker to the next may be quite different. And I feel like we've all developed abilities, and we call it the psychic senses, differently. Everybody is unique in their own being, in the way they may present things and do certain energy work. And vice versa, some people might not practice the same kind of energy work I do, or maybe do things the way I do. I believe that energy workers were put on this earth to really help people, guide people, become spiritual leaders and help other people. I feel like it's a very special gift to understand that everybody is born with psychic senses. And some people have been able to just develop their psychic senses, or they were just born with knowing that they have psychic senses. Now, when I talk about psychic senses, it's the Clair senses. So Clair senses means clear senses. I wanted to bring up that developing your psychic senses is a lot like having a musical background. So being able to sing, for example, or playing an instrument, you have to practice. Everyone's born with being able to, maybe not singing, because singing is something very special and a lot of people just have it. Same with developing your psychic senses. Some people just have it and have a natural ability to be able to tap into it. And some people might need a little more education or work to get to that point of using your psychic senses. Now, not everybody's gonna want to get there. Some people are skeptical and some people just don't want to be involved in that, or they're interested and curious, but they're not curious to the point where they want to become an energy worker. And that's fine. That's great. That's what we're here for. I also want to get into the idea of how I identify myself. Now, I have always identified myself as an intuitive because I was really worried about saying I'm psychic. Because I believe a lot of people have this misconception that if you're psychic, you should be able to see lottery numbers. Now, this is a huge misconception. Maybe there is someone that's clairvoyant that can see numbers. I don't really think that this is what it should be used to predict lottery numbers. Otherwise, we'd all be millionaires. Oh, and if I had a nickel for every time someone came up to me in the market and asked me for their lucky numbers, I would be a millionaire right now. But I honestly don't believe that that's what we should be using our skills for, but I could be wrong. Again, we're all different. So back to being a psychic. There's a lot of misinformation about psychics, mediums, intuitives. And I just want to clarify a little bit about that and talk about the different clair senses today. So that's the clear senses. If you've been able to identify with almost all seven of them or more than one, then you have probably been able to develop your psychic senses. Now, I just want to mention, I brought up the market. So what I meant by that is I was in the farmer's market for the last year and really been able to develop my skills professionally as a tarot card reader. I have been reading cards for 20 years, but I wasn't doing it always professionally. I was involved in a lot of fundraisers and I did a lot of group events for my girlfriends, parties, So I was able to develop my skills for a really long time, but doing it professionally in the market was last year. I had my own booth. It was really cool. I had my own little setup, my own little tent. It was a great experience. I learned so much, and I was able to develop my skills so much through the market that last year. And now we're here on YouTube. I brought up mediumship before, and the difference from being psychic and being a medium. Now I want to clarify, not every psychic is a medium, but most mediums are psychics, if that makes sense. So when we talk about mediums, they can talk to the other side. They have been able to tap into something where they talk to people that have passed. Now, I don't have any skill in this. I have not been able to develop being able to talk to the other side. I have tried many times, but it's just not something I have ever been able to develop. And that's okay because I have psychic abilities. So I have psychic senses. And I still believe that I do identify as an intuitive because I am highly intuitive. And I want to go through the seven different psychic senses, but there is actually eight. But it's a bit confusing because there is four senses that get confused with each other. I will go through all the senses, and in my next video, I want to talk more in depth about the Clair senses because there's a lot covered in here, and there's a lot of different information out there about this. So I just want to go through what I understand about it and all the senses that I actually identify with about all eight of them a little bit, but I really strongly identify with about six of them. When you're developing psychic senses, you may identify with one or two or all eight. Now, this is saying that your psychic senses are just more developed and you have been able to tap into something and understand and develop your senses more so, which is great. And if you only have one or two senses, this is very powerful as well. You've been able to tap into something that some people are just not able to tap into. So I want to start with clairvoyance because this is the most known one. Almost everybody has heard the word clairvoyance, and clairvoyance means all seeing, so visions. Now, I'm going to go through the list of the clair senses, but I want to get into it more in depth in the next video. All right, so claircognizance and clairsentience often get mixed up a bit. So claircognizance is all knowing, and so is clairsentience, but clairsentience is also feeling, so feeling that it's all feeling. But also, we have clairempathy. So clairempathy is also about feeling. So, but clairempathy is about clairempathy means feeling the emotion, and clairsentience is when you feel the actual feeling of another person, when you can take on that feeling of someone. Another one is clairtangency. Clairtangency is about clear touch. So you can pick up an object and feel the energy coming from that object. They're also touching a person and feeling the energy from them. They're all kind of tied into each other a little bit, but they are very specific in their own way. So with clear touch, it could also be related to picking up on feelings of someone, but more the experience that someone has experienced, being able to touch an object or someone and pick up on that energy. Now, the next one we have is clear audience. So clear audience is clear hearing. So you hear something and then it's like hearing a message. And the next one is clairaugustance, and this is clear taste. Now, this is kind of an awkward one, and I want to get into it a little bit more in my next video because this one is a little bit hard to explain what you mean by being able to predict or understand energy through taste. Now, the next psychic sense I want to talk about is clairalience, which is clear smelling. Now, this is also one that I want to get into my next video because it deserves a bit of an explanation. All right, there we have it. We have all eight clair senses, all eight psychic senses. Thank you very much for tuning in, and I apologize if my pronunciation was a bit off. Those were very, very hard words to pronounce. So thank you very much for following my channel, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button below and to like my video, my very first video. I'm very, very excited about this journey. Thank you from Sacred Tarot Nicole.